Hello, everyone. My name is Lil. I'm working at the Austrian Research Promotion Agency as expert for European research funding. In the next minutes, I will explain you the main features of the Marie Skłodowska-Curie European Postdoctoral Fellowship. From the introduction to the postdoctoral fellowship, you already know that the fellowship is funding for researchers holding a PhD for a research project in any scientific area. There is no age restriction, but there is a limit to the scientific age of the researcher. And you already know that the researcher has to go abroad. So what are the special features of the European Fellowship? Let's start with the researcher. The researcher can be of any nationality. Our researcher, Dr. Marie, for example, is Swedish, but she could be Brazilian, Korean, Australian, whatever. Second, a European fellowship is a joint application with Dr. Marie and the host organization and the supervisor of her choice in Europe, meaning in the European Union or in a country that is associated to Horizon Europe. This is why this fellowship type is called a European fellowship. The host organization can be an organization in the academic or in the non-academic sector. For example, Dr. Marie plans to apply with a research institute in Austria. There is one exception related to the fellow's nationality and to the country of the host, and you can see it on the slide. This is relevant only for projects in the area of nuclear research. If you are unsure about this, please get in touch with us. Now, before you start designing your research project with your ideal host, you need to check if you comply with the mobility rule for the European Fellowship, which you see here on the screen. The researcher must not have resided, worked, studied in the country of the beneficiary, this meaning the country of your host organization in Europe, for more than 12 months in the 3 years before the deadline. So you need to look at your CV and check where you have spent the last 3 years before the call deadline. You need to be sure that you did not spend more than 12 months in the country where your future host organization is located, not even a single day above these 12 months. This is a strict rule, and in case you do not comply, you are out of the game without anyone reading your application, no matter how exciting your project might be. Dr. Marie, for example, would need to check if she complies with the rule related to Austria, since this is where her host is located. She did spend time in Austria in the last 3 years before the deadline, but it was less than 12 months. So she can go for a fellowship with a host organization in Austria. Now, let us have a look at some more options. Overall, the duration of a European fellowship can be between 1 and 2 years. Apart from the time spent at your host organization, you can include secondments. These are periods of research and training activities at another organization, if you consider this important for your project. You can plan such a secondment at an academic or a non-academic organization. It can be located in the same country where your host organization is located, but also anywhere else in the world. So think about it. Maybe there is a good reason for you to spend some time also at another organization during the fellowship, in addition to your host organization, at another university, another research institute or lab, a company, NGO, etc. It is also possible to have several secondment periods and also to different organizations if you think that this is needed. Yet the maximum duration to spend time on secondments is limited to 1/3 of the overall duration of the fellowship. For example, with a 2-year fellowship, the maximum time spent on secondments is 8 months. Apart from secondments, you can also plan field trips and short visits for all sorts of reasons. Another interesting option is to include at the end of the fellowship a so-called additional placement in the non-academic sector. Such a placement can be anywhere in Europe, including the city or country where your host organization is located. A placement can have a duration of up to 6 months, which means that the overall duration of a European fellowship can be up to 2.5 years. With the additional placement, the European Commission, the funder, wants to provide an incentive for postdoctoral researchers to actually spend time also in the non-academic sector to discover career options there for the time after the fellowship. These were the main features of the European Fellowship. In the next video, we will have a closer look at the Global Fellowship. Have a nice day and see you there.